Hello, I'm Donna.
I'm Sarah.
This is Ryan. And today, he's going to be telling us all about the Common Data Service. You don't know what that is? You got to tune in. See you soon. Hello, welcome to Less Code, More Power. I'm Donna.
I'm Sarah.
Today we have a very exciting guest, a pro dev in the wild.
This literally is such an epic show. We have got the master of the Common Data Service, Ryan Jones, with us today, like in the flesh. So thank you so much for being with us today.
Thank you so much for having me. Those are very kind words.
So Ryan, tell us all about you. What do you do? What's the deal? How'd you make your way to Power Platform anyway?
So that's a great question. So I actually come from Azure. I joined about Dynamics. Dynamics and Power Apps joined about 2 years ago. Mm-hmm. When I was in Azure, I built a thing called Azure Resource Manager.
It's how you provision
like all the stuff in Azure. Mm-hmm. And that's actually how I got to know Charles, our fearless leader.
So. Wonderful. And now you work on Common Data Service. Do you want to tell us a little about that?
Yeah. So the idea with the Common Data Service is we want to make it easy to structure a variety of business data and business logic to support a bunch of little apps that work together in a secure and compliant manner.
Love it. That's fantastic. What do you think is interesting about Common Data Service that people do not know? Misconceptions?
Well, so a lot of times when people draw like Common Data Service on the whiteboard, they draw the like database oil can.
Oh, yeah, we know that one.
And it, to quote Family Guy, grinds my gears. Because CDS is so much more than a database.
So much more.
Right? Whether it comes to all our business logic stuff, whether it comes to the way that we store stuff in SQL, and we store it in Azure Blob, and we store it in Azure Search, and we store a little bit in Cosmos DB, and a little bit in Azure Data Lake. Mm-hmm. Like, we do so many more, like, way cool things beyond just what you can do in a relational data store. Plus, I really think it's cool how we make it really easy to do. Like, if you can build a Power App, you can build a complex multi-tier application using the Common Data Service. And so I think that's pretty cool.
Yes, because you've made the UI so, you know, available to people. Like, it's easy. It's not, you're not going in some weird kind of like tool that was made about 40 years ago to kind of like go ahead and like actually, you know, create entities or tables.
Yeah, I joke it's so easy a musician can do it.
You are a musician.
I do play a little bit of music. My undergrad degree is actually in music technology.
That's cool.
So he's a musician by trade and definition, not kind of a musician.
Yeah.
So what kind of music?
Oh, I played a little bit of everything over the years.
Wow, okay. So. That's cool.
And you're also a race car driver.
Mm-hmm. I want to be. I've gone to racing school a few times.
Wow. That's cool.
I haven't wrecked anything yet, but also my lap times weren't anything.
This sounds like a good race car driver, one who hasn't crashed into anything.
Yes. Yeah. Well, you know, if you haven't crashed, you haven't tried hard enough.
I don't know if that works. That works in being a dev. I don't know if that works in race cars as much, but hey.
If it's somebody else's car.
Then it's true. Okay.
Exactly. Yes.
And as long as you got your helmet on.
Yes, and as long as you can walk away.
Yes.
Exactly. So, will you show us some cool CDS stuff?
We
hear you have treats for the audience.
Yeah,
so one of the cool things that we've been working on lately is how to make it easier to work with files and images within the Common Data Service. Yeah. And so I'll just go ahead and show you what this looks like. So I'm going to create an entity for doing home inspections.
Cool.
And we'll call this, Channel 9 Inspections. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to click Create. And while it's doing that in the background, I'm going to start adding fields.
That sounds great, Channel 9 Inspections.
Let's see. We'll go, and this will be like home inspections. Yeah. So we'll get a picture of the front of the house and a picture of the back of the house and a floor plan, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I'll call this field front. I will make it an image, and then I'm going to go into my advanced options. I'm going to say can store full size images, and I'll also make it the primary image. And then I'll do this exact same thing, but for the back of the house. So back, and I'll select image.
Cool.
And then I will say it can store the full size image. And so what we've done here is made a bunch of improvements where number one, you can store multiple images on a single record, single entity.
Yeah.
The other thing that we've done is made it so that you can store the full size image in addition to the little thumbnails.
Mm-hmm.
And we do some cool voodoo behind the scenes so that the little image goes into SQL, so like lists are really fast, like in your galleries and Power Apps. But then when you drill in to a record, you get to work with the full size image, so you don't get all the little jaggies
That's
everywhere.
Right, that's right. Oh, cool.
So and then
and
I'll
it does that without you having to do any extra work.
Exactly. That's exactly. Because cool. I'm too busy trying to drive race cars and
play the guitar.
Exactly.
Well, that's
yes.
amazing though, because yeah. like one of my pet hates is low res images.
Yes.
Like as in, I know this maybe sounds like a very privileged pet hate, mm-hmm. but in terms of like when you're doing a lot of work, especially yes. like design work or even yes. you know blogs and
that's right.
all that kind of stuff, low res images can ruin all the hard work and
that's
stuff
right.
behind the scenes.
Yeah, so like my entity created here behind the scenes, and so now what I'm gonna do is we'll create an app using that.
Oh, okay.
And so you'll notice I'm not creating like a million different like connections to Azure storage for yeah. this thing and SQL for that thing. Yep. I just connect to the common data service.
Just connect to the table. Even though it utilizes yep. more than one.
That's right.
And so it's going to do all of its magic
things. Look at
things.
The Power App magic happen. This is my favorite part, where the machine builds an app for you, and you did not have to build it.
Well, and the thing is, yes. I'm like the world's worst designer, and so this is the best looking
for
app
me,
I can
my
build.
My Power Apps look like this
yes.
because I am not a UI person, and I know no idea about UI. I'm like, look, it works.
Exactly, exactly. Yeah. We always joke, UI is the other Ryan.
Yes, yes.
So let's see. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go through and say I want the front mm-hmm. and the back and the floor plan. And by default, what we do for like performance and reliability reasons,
yeah.
we use the little thumbnails,
yeah.
but it's really easy to start going through and using the full size image. And so if I wanted to go through and say, hey, you know what, this guy, this front image right here, I want to go through and make that the full size image. I'm just going to, danger, I'm going to unlock.
Oh.
I'm going to go advanced here.
Fancy.
But then dot full.
And that's it. So you don't even need to like do anything. You don't even need to change that in no. any kind of extensive way. It's just a case of
I
dot
like
full.
That. Okay, I didn't
that's
know
it.
This.
Cool. Yeah, and so I go yeah. do the same thing on like the back and then on mm-hmm. my edit screen as well.
Yeah.
But that's it. All of a sudden, I'm now working with images, both mm-hmm. thumbnails,
yeah.
full-size images stored in different places, but that's it. Like, if you were to ask a pro dev, you know, I play one on TV,
yes.
to do that, it'd take them like 2 weeks to build that exact same thing.
Oh, if they know what they're doing.
Yes, exactly. Yes.
If they're a UI person also.
And then we also, like, we don't just want to have apps and data. We want you to be able to take action and automate on it.
That's
so
right.
if I go over to my automate experience mm-hmm. right here,
yes.
you can see where I've created a flow where when an inspection is created,
yes.
it'll go through and retrieve that full size image.
Yes.
And then it'll turn around and send an email.
I love it.
And so, you know, here's an example, new inspection for 4312 Dead End Drive,
yes.
where it attached that full size
yeah.
image.
That's actually like from an organizational perspective, mm-hmm. you know, it's kind of important to making sure we've got those full res images because
right.
detail, like inspections are actually kind of important
yes.
when we need the actual high res.
Exactly.
Detail.
Like you need to be able to see that scratch in the corner.
Yeah.
Like versus saying there's a scratch in the corner where. Yeah, absolutely. That's
this
very
is
very important. This is really,
yeah.
really cool. I love that.
Well, thank you.
I learned a bunch of new stuff right now.
Yeah. But it's one of the things that would be really good for you to just kind of explain to our audience is a little bit about how CDS does that, like in terms of kind of going to, you know, the fact that CDS is more than, you know, you mentioned about the, you know, the oil can and all
yep.
that kind of stuff, is that tell the audience why it is so much kind of better, what services it provides is the common data service.
That's a great question. So when I think about the common data service, we always start with this API. And this API, like, it isn't something that you have to interact with.
Yeah.
If you are a pro dev, you can, but that's always central to everything we do.
Mm-hmm.
Everything we do is exposed through our OData APIs, whether that is describing the shape of an entity or allowing you to create, read, update, delete a record for a given entity, we all start with that API. And then beyond that, we then have a security layer, right? Because we think this is like supporting all these different business applications,
right.
they store customer data, all this stuff that's really important to be secured. And so we have all the authentication, authorization, auditing stuff. Like, I mean, I don't know, on one hand, you could say it's kind of boring,
yeah.
not very exciting, but on the other hand, if you don't have it, you're really
there's
in a
issues.
Rough spot. So
yeah.
you gotta have it, right? And so from there, we go into our business logic layer
right.
where, you know, we understand things like, oh, this is an image. Oh, the maximum size of an image is such and such. Oh, this value should be more than or less than that value,
mm-hmm.
right? And then we get into our data tier where you can go through and describe the shape of your data, where you can define calculated fields, roll-up fields. And then we get into the storage tier, which is where we do all the magic SQL and Azure
yeah.
Blob and Azure
yeah.
Search and Cosmos DB stuff.
Similar to what we saw today.
Exactly. Yes. And then we have like our integration connectivity where we push it into like Azure Service Bus, Event
right.
Hubs, invoke webhooks through Azure Functions. So all of these things where like If you were to try to build that from the ground up, you'd be doing it for like a bajillion years.
Oh, easy.
So
easy. Just thinking through the connectors will take you a very long time.
Yes, yes.
And we've done the thinking and incorporated it so anyone can use it.
Exactly. Yes.
I love that. That is so cool.
It is, right? One of the things, though, I really want to make sure that we mention is the CDM and how that links a little bit with, because the thing is, there's going to be, and I know that it's starting out very much like an airplane taking off right now with, in terms of the Power Platform data flows, but could you just give people, tell our audience a little bit about what that is and why that's, again, critical to the Common Data Service?
Well, so when we look at data, we have to understand the shape of that data, right? Yeah. Because if we don't understand the shape of the data, we can't easily move that data from one system to another. And so when we look at the common data model, of course, there's like a language, which is a way that we describe the shape of that data. But then what we've done is we've used that language to describe the shape of commonly used business entities, like account, like contact, so on and so forth. And by doing so, one is we're able to kind of like build an ecosystem around that so that we aren't all arguing about what the appropriate shape of an account should be, right? And then, of course, because it's standardized and because it's well-documented in a machine-readable format, we can then facilitate how we move that data between different systems, like CDS, like Power BI, like Azure Data Lake. Mm-hmm. And it's really exciting to me because it used to be when you'd have these complicated integration scenarios, you'd start by arguing about how you were going to,
what a contact
is. It starts
with the fight.
Is, right?
Yeah. Until the fight happens, you're not even making progress.
Yes, and then it's like, oh, well, now we know what a contact is, but how are we going to describe it?
Right.
And then you're like, oh, okay, well, now we know those two things, but we still have to make these two systems talk together.
Right.
There's all these questions that through the common data model, you no longer have to answer.
Right.
And we see that customers are able to be much more successful in their deployments just because it's ready to go. And so, like CDM, there's 100 entities in the Common Data Service out of the box that are ready to go following the Common Data Model.
Wow.
Account, contact.
Cool.
There are a couple custom entities here as well, so you can see here sort. But, you know, there's a lot of goodies in here. Here we'll scroll past custom. We can tell we do a little bit of testing there. But a bunch of standard entities that are there from day
zero. Yeah, I like feedback. That's good because a lot of people have that same need. Right?
Yes.
We hear from all the time, how do you collect feedback? How do you collect feedback? Like, well, let's make a way that everyone can just do it.
Exactly, because every organization, every industry does something like that.
Everyone has the same one.
It's funny, because like talking about industries with the CDM, right, this is where you get the industry accelerators.
Yes.
This is where we've got the healthcare the non-for-profit accelerator, these kind of things. And if anyone hasn't seen the like non-for-profit accelerator, go ahead and check that out. We'll put it in show notes.
Yeah.
But you know, these are the things that now, I bet you're so excited, just the possibilities that are going to come up.
Yeah, yeah, so we see, cool it's all these people partnering together, working together and building these cool things together as a community, furthering specific industries or across industries as well.
Love it. So before Ryan leaves us, we're going to ask you for a call to action.
Okay.
We'd love for you to assign the audience some homework.
Okay.
What do you want everyone to go and try today?
Yep.
So here's what I'd ask. Go home, spin up your Common Data Service environment, create an entity using an image, full-size image, with a file, and build a Power App and flow over the top of it.
Whoa.
You'll find it super easy and opens up a whole bunch of cool new app scenarios that weren't possible in the past.
That's amazing. What a cool call to action.
That's a great call to action. Perfect. Thank you so much for being with us today, and thank you to Ryan.
Yes, thank you so much.
Thanks for having me. It was a lot of fun.
Of course. Till next time, less code,
more power.